Oh yeah, we got Mr. Cartoon in the building here at K-Day, man.
That's right, what's up, homie?
How you, brother, man? It's good to have you through, man.
Good to be here, doggy.
For real, it was cool getting to talk to you, catch up with you on the phone right around the time the Sidekick 2 was coming out.
Right, right. That was crazy, because Tmobile set up some press for me, you know what I mean? So, you know, we call all over the U.S. and talk to different people, you know what I mean? But it's really important, man, for me to focus right here on home, where I grew up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Come out here. Especially K-Day, you know what I mean? I grew up listening to it, so good to see you guys make that big comeback. You know?
Man, yeah, definitely, dog. I love seeing a cat like yourself, man, coming up from L.A.
Right.
And doing it like it's hot, man, because I look at like 50, for example, who's created right. this empire.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? From music to movies to soundtrack to vitamin water, you know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
And all of that, and I'm like, yo, Mr. Cartoon, on the real, bro, like you've done it from tattoos to sneakers to Sidekicks to album artwork. I mean, you branched out, bro, and it was starting with, and tattoos is what did it, starting in the hood.
That's right. You know, tattoos are something that really blew it up. It's funny, man, because like, I was talking to Julio G the other day on the radio, and we were talking about how I started at the Rhodium Swap Meet in Gardena. I just got a box of white t-shirts, and I was actually airbrushing t-shirts in my garage. Little did I know I was being a clothing designer, you know what I mean?
Right.
I was just trying to airbrush some
right.
shirts for the homies, you know what I mean? And I actually find my place in hip-hop, how I fit in, because I remember in the 80s, fools were breakdancing, and other fools were,
right.
were DJing or popping or whatever, and for me, clumsy as I was, I had to stick to the graffiti side of town, you know what I mean?
Yep.
So I got into graffiti art, man, and I didn't start off with a big plan of I'm going to take over and do cell phones and
right,
do all
right.
this, rappers and all. I kind of just did it because I wanted to stand out and I wanted to be involved in this hip-hop culture, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
So it's never stopped since then. You know, it's been a 20-year process, a slow process, but a fun process.
Right, and it's crazy to me, man, because it's like what hip-hop is doing right now and then seeing that, you know, the evolution for you, you know what I mean?
Right.
Like you said, you just started with t-shirts, bro. Like, I remember the Airbrush t-shirts, you know
yeah.
what I mean? And those were hot. And it was like, I remember, what was it like, the cartoon? What do you think it was, man, for you that was different from everyone else? Whereas to everyone else went color, you know what I mean? And you've always been classic. Even the box on the Sidekick is the black and gray, you know
that's
what
right,
I mean?
That's right. You know what it is that I wanted to incorporate LA culture into hip-hop.
Because
when people think about hip-hop, they think about New York, Drake, you know, subway trains, Caesar in your hair, rolling up one hand leg.
Right.
You know, in that style, right? Which is their style. And in the 80s, fools out here were trying to do that.
Right, right, yeah.
And then we kind of were like, okay, well, we need to stick to LA. This is us. We need to have our own style. So when I look at a lowrider car, I think of hip-hop because I think about the custom paint, the murals, the pinstriping, the person driving it.
Right.
You know, so I wanted to incorporate a lowrider lifestyle into hip-hop. So I think that's where I brought my thing in to where I stepped to the traditions of not only lowriding and Chicano art, but the high quality to hip-hop and to be original, to take those old icons and flip it and put it into my look.
And it's hot, bro. It's because your
Thank
look,
you.
Man, is on everyone right now, from 50 to Eminem to Beyonce to Travis right. from Blink. There's all, I mean, how you tell me, bro, some of the ones I'm missing. I know Tretch from Naughty by Nature's got a big
right.
piece on his back. That you did?
Right, Nas, Dr. Dre, Kanye, Missy, Beyonce. I mean, you know what's crazy about it is that those are such powerful names, such big names in the industry. But what really blows me away is Harley from Harley Bail Bonds, the Mexican dude that's a bail bondsman who has a full-blown back piece.
Wow.
He drives a 7 Series, an S-Class. I mean, dude is... He lives his life quality, right? And he's a star in his own street,
yeah.
a street star, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then I do a school teacher. He's an elementary school teacher. He's got a full-blown back piece. He's has quarter sleeves. And he's there working every day with kids. But it's crazy because those guys don't get a lot of shine.
Right.
Because people don't really recognize their name or whatever. But it goes from those characters to... I get the guy that been working at Home Depot for 5 years and is putting his chippies away, eating top ramen, so he can afford them. Quality bomb tattoo,
man. So that was one of the records that has kind of inspired the work that you do today.
Yeah, I mean, hearing a fun scratch like that and hearing the rhyme style change. And I remember, when NWA came in, you know, really, Egyptian Lover hit me before all of that. And I remember everyone freaking and you know, all that Egyptian Lover, you know, Uncle Jam's Army, man.
Like, right.
Man, you know, that just was on. My whole artwork changed.
Is that what it is, bro, that's got you doing stuff now, like for the youth in the community, because of that was your influence as a youth?
Yeah, you know, it was so difficult for me to learn anything, man. I mean, it seemed like anybody that had any type of knowledge in this sport of murals or pinstriping or custom art, street art, they didn't want to share it. And so I had to learn most of it by myself. And I figured out that it's all common knowledge, man. If you practice every single day at what you want to do, and you always look to improve your artwork and to be, you know, to be dope and don't bite nobody. And your artwork, then you'll get good, you know what I mean? So it's a skill. But I think my purpose, and I know my homeboy Stevon's purpose, is to work with these kids, because what it does is that when you get into hip hop, it's a lot about ego. I'm dope,
right,
I'm fly,
right.
Check me out, check out my steel, you know what I mean?
Right.
And then when you work with kids, your attention is on them, so it's off of yourself, you know what I'm saying? So it balances you out. Say, hey, let me hand this art culture to these youngsters, and I dare them to do something with it, you know what I'm saying? Like Joker Clothing, like we started that out of our garage. And now we have, distributors in Germany. We got distributors in Japan. It's world. Like our second biggest, population of customers is in Germany. So that's crazy that they would embrace our lifestyle.
Man, big up, Mr. Cartoon, because it's an inspiration, bro. And I'm gonna tell you, like, for myself, it's real inspiring to me, man. Because it just gives me that. All right, cool, man. I came up in the hood, so word. You know what I'm saying? You did too, bro, and I see you doing it.
Right.
And it's inspiring to me, man. And I hope everyone listening right now is going to get out there and support everything you're doing, man, as a Latino. And just, you're doing everything, bro. You've done it. You know what I'm saying? And you're continuing, and much success. Continued success.
Thank you, man. I mean, it's crazy because we're just getting started.
Right.
I mean, we've been doing this for 20 years, right? I mean, I think it was actually 20 years ago that I started airbrushing at the Rhodium, at least my garage, and airbrushing these t-shirts. Like I had an airbrush and everything. So 20 years later, people are like, hey, Holmes, you're lucky, man. You know, you get to do all this. And
it's right,
like, man,
right.
You know, lucky is with people that win the lottery. You know what I mean? Like, we really worked at this. And doing this Tmobile Sidekick, this is something crazy because it's a phone. It's an organizer.
Yeah.
It's like a mini computer. It's, you know, you can email, talk.
It's hot, dude. It's like one of my... I can't leave the house without my Sidekick, man.
You get sprung on it.
Yeah.
Man. And you know what? We wanted to do it real stealth. We wanted to do it black. We wanted it to, you know, have the classic tattoo images on it.
That's what it is, too. Like, the cartoons, like, on the back, like, you got the clown face. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just hot, bro. It's so street, man. You street with it. It's T-Mobile, man. It's everywhere, worldwide.
But it's crazy because I wanted some corporate dude who don't know who I am just to see the phone and be like, hey, that's a black Sidekick. I got to get that Sidekick. You know what I mean? But it's crazy, man. We're going to venture off and do rims, our own custom three-piece. 24-inch rims, 22-inch rims, man.
You got a website now. So for the regular person who's out working hard right now, man, it's like, man, I want to get a Mr. Cartoon tat. I've been saving my cheese. How can they get a hold of you? Is there an email or something?
Yeah, if they go to MrCartoon.com, you can just always Google my name and Mr. Cartoon, and the website comes up first. But there's a whole process on how to do it. It's easy. You send a deposit in. You get the deposit. We call you back. And our system gives you an appointment. But on the emails, man, people are like, well, how much for this? I can be there all day answering people, window shopper. You know what I'm saying? They want to go window shopping on the floor. I got things.
Right.
So you send a deposit in, and that means you're for real. And that separates you.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Window shopper.
That's talking. Now you're talking. Let's get to it right there. Now I'm a sneakerhead, bro.
That's right.
Are there any new sneakers coming out, man? Any Air Force Ones, Cortez? What you got going, man?
To be honest with you, on the 25th of this month, it's the Nike Cortez Aztec version. When you see this one, you ain't even gonna recognize it as a Cortez, because there's no stitching on the side. It's super clean. There's not even a Nike check. It has an Aztec Warrior head on the side of it, and it has a gum bottom. It's real clean, homie. So you wear a black tee, some shorts, black fitted, and those Cortezes, And it's on. You know, I had to do I had to do a Cortez because I grew up wearing them.
Yeah.
And Air Force Ones are the best-selling shoe in the world. But Cortezes are from, you know, we made them famous. So I have to stick. I know Little Easy always rocks them.
Yeah.
So it's you know.
Nah, Cortez was the hood shoe, man. Everybody had Cortez and karate shoes.
That's right.
Yeah, pair of one of those.
I'm gonna bring you up some over here because we got to talk about just the what goes beyond the whole Nike thing that we did.
Yeah.
We do a lot of outreaches for kids and. You know, we me and Esteban will get in front of a bunch of kids, man, and we'll rap to them. And I'll say, look, if I made a shoe, you can make a shoe.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? But you got it. It's not that easy, man. You got to be original with yours. You got to be sick with it.
Yeah.
You got to have skill. Yeah. And skill is developed over years, man. There's no shortcut for skill, man. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And that's what a lot of kids, I think they get it twisted, man. And they see that, you know, oh, I want all this and I want that. But you know what?
Work for it.
Yeah. Bottom line, you got to work. Yeah. You got to take direction too, man. You got to listen to your parents. Mm-hmm. You got to listen to your elders and stuff and people that you know who's on your side and take some direction, man. Because no one ever learned nothing when they were talking.
Right, exactly, dude. Mr. Cartoon, good lucky, man, coming through. I'm going to definitely have you come through, man, when them Cortez come out, bro.
That's right, you know.
Come back and hang out.
I got to say what's up to Julio G, man. I don't know, that's the
whole
thing. The South Big Rube, Angel Baby. Julie, Baby Tunes, Liliana, that's right,
man. Big shout out to Esteban too, hanging out over here, man,
right here, now. He's chilling, he don't mean no arms, getting rid of expensive taste, Joker brand clothes.
There it is, man, Mr. Cartoon, hanging out here in K&A, man, 310-552-9935, anything you want to hear, we got you with that hip hop from today, back in the day.
Get you.